All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we are. We're going to make the front of this birdhouse. All right, so our drawings show us a image that looks like this. We've got a pentagon, a five-sided polygon here, 45-degree angles. I got a half-inch diameter hole here, quarter-inch diameter hole here. You'll need to measure the overall height. Well, we got a width here and a height, so looks like we can get most of this in without these other measurements. So I question whether you even need all those measurements. But anyway, here you have it. Go ahead from your sketch. Let's roll on over to our birdhouse. Of course, by this point, we've already constructed most of it. So let's see what we can do. Go ahead and produce a sketch on the front of this component. And then view normal to the plane by tapping N on your keyboard. Let's go ahead and see. Yep, looks like our, I know we had a 45 degree line, so let's go ahead and start here. And when we bring that mouse over here, you can see that the line will automatically snap to the corners. If it doesn't, you can hover over it, right click and choose use. And that'll allow you to, matter of fact, I can just hit the use. Should be able to get all those. No, didn't do all of them yet. Might have worked. Let's see if that works. It looks like it's shaded. So if that worked, we'll rename that the front. Check mark, that does appear like it finished in. So go ahead and extrude that. Identify, we'll pick the entire front sketch. Look at that. Of course, you're going to want to use the dimension that you measured for the thickness. I'm just throwing an arbitrary 0.25 in there. That is a, back into that, that is a new part. And there you have it. We were able to add that front on. Now, we haven't done the holes yet, so we'll go back into that, and we can add those after the fact, or we can go back and modify it. But just a quick review what the heck we did. We produced the sketch by using the line tool to start drawing the polygon. We could have drawn it all by hand, making sure that we get a grid snap on the corners, or we could just hover over a line in the drawing and choose use. So even though that line, that edge, wasn't part of the original of the sketch, the new sketch, this is a part of an old sketch, we can use it on this sketch on shape and see that for us. That was pretty helpful. Other things we could always do, you can always go in there and add angles. So if we wanted, we saw in our drawing that we had a 45 degree angle. So we could have used our dimensions to draw along here and then draw at an angle. So for example, if I want to draw a pentagon, I could have come in here, drawn across, drawn vertical, and then just kind of close that off and use our vertical line constraint. Horizontal line constraint, vertical line constraint, and then we could have come in and set the angles using the dimension tool to dimension the angle between those lines. Remember, it said 45 was the number, so there you go. And 45. Could have done it. Oops. That way, of course, these two sides would need to be whatever measurement you measured. So. To get it whatever shape you're looking for. So trust your measurements and create what you need to create to make those parts. Oh, we have that extra part, so let's go back into the sketch. We need that. That's how you get it started. And of course, if you want to add those those holes. We can add another sketch on there for the holes, or we could have drawn them in the same sketch. Let's go back into the sketch and add those holes. I'm going to use the circle tool, and let's find the midpoint. So you can see the midpoint icon showing up there. That's that line with the dot in the middle. I'm going to take my mouse, make sure it lines up there. We'll draw a circle somewhere at whatever the value was in the instructions. I think it was 0.25, I believe, was the value they gave us. Then we're going to draw the other circle directly above that, which I believe lined up with the corner there. And they give us a value of 0.5. Let's double check those measurements. It was 0.5. Yep, 0.25. Now the height value, we have to measure that using our calipers here. So you can see, read that on your dial caliper. What am I reading? I'm reading 0 inches, 1 tenth, 2 tenths, 3 tenths, 4 tenths, 4 tenths. So 0.4. 0.427. So we could give that a height value from the bottom of the object up to the center point at 0.427, like we measured. That's awfully low. But remember, your birdhouse is drawn from those dimensions, and my birdhouse, I just made up as I went along. Let's go back to the model. And yes, this center point lined up with the side edge. So center point of the top hole lines up with the top of the sides. There you go. And look at that. There's your birdhouse with a hole in it. Okay. Hopefully this helps. As always, go be awesome.